Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Greedfall. Now, this game is super freaking interesting because it borrows inspiration clearly from The Witcher 3, but it mixes in enough of its own ingredients to be intriguing on its own. And what's fascinating to me is that 2019 has seen a resurgence in the mid-tier game, which is awesome for all of us. I feel like this sector of the gaming industry kind of vanished the last couple of years, but it's back in full force, and Greedfall is a great example. Definitely let me know in the comments down below what you think of the game after you watch me play it for a bit. Smash that like button if you enjoy and are pumped to see such awesome variety this year. It's really, really cool because mid-tier games not only come in at a lower price point, but they sometimes bring in really unique ideas that aren't safe enough for a AAA franchise or a major publisher. You know, things that are actually really, really good ideas, but wouldn't quite cut it for a game in a very popular freaking franchise. So Greedfall is $50, and it is an RPG, and it has incredible early buzz. So we're going to check it out together here. Probably just be one big video, giving a good look at the game, letting you know my thoughts. Unless I fall in love with it, or you guys fall in love with it, then maybe we'll do more. But right now, just let this be known that it is probably a one video thing. But thanks so much for your support. I super appreciate you guys helping the resurgence of Ghost Robo. It has been awesome to see. We're in the freaking positive in terms of subscriber growth, views, all that good stuff. It has been an amazing couple weeks. I can feel the energy building, and it's because of you. And it's because, like, September is the new November this year. We've got Gears, Control, Man of Dawn, PVZ, Borderlands soon, Zelda and the Switch Lite soon, and hopefully Greedfall can be added to that list. We're gonna dive in and see what it's all about, create a character, and figure out if this is the next Western RPG obsession or something that falls flat. But I'm very, very eager. So thanks for being here. Let's dive in. Greedfall begins right about now.
Could you stand a little taller, just a tad?
Like this?
Yes, yes. The chin a tiny bit lower. Gaze a little more to the right. There! Now, hold the pose!
Well, they already showed my face. I thought they were going to do the thing where you can't see the character. But we've got guys and girls with a very eerie tattoo right there. Ooh, skills. This is going to be awesome. You can start off as a technical who controls the battlefield as a warrior who focuses on melee combat. Or magic, spells from a distance. That seems pretty freaking cool. Stasis, one-handed heavy weapons, divine magic ring. But blades also seems pretty awesome. Firearms and blades, I don't know, magic is tempting as all heck, but this technical, controlling the battlefield, like, I like that a lot. Melee, probably not my thing, but having guns and blades from afar, pretty freaking sweet. All right, let's create a character. Let's see what some of the presets look like. Everyone's looking very regal. I feel like this is Pirates of the Caribbean, but not on the Jack Sparrow side, you know? This is on the other side of the equation. We've got guys and girls. What do they look like over here? Oh, pretty good variety, I'd say. Kind of want to make a sweet female character. You know, since we're talking about the Witcher 3 comparisons, obviously, you're a dude there. So I'm trying to think of a way that we might be able to make this a lot different, kind of like an opposite Witcher. Let's start here and see what we can do. Alrighty, so we can't modify this tattoo at all. It's got to be there. So there's got to be some lore story reason for that. It does say up top that the skill tree is open. You'll be able to unlock the skills of other archetypes as you progress. So I think I want to go technical, and then we'll add some magic in, and maybe warrior as well. But this also gives us lockpicking, which I like. So we're going to start technical. That feels pretty good. Ooh, pick an attribute to invest your first point according to your preferred playstyle. Endurance, accuracy, willpower, mental power, agility, fury generation. I don't even know what that is. Okay, so what did they recommend for us here? They recommended accuracy and agility. So that'll be damage and armored damage, and this is physical damage and fury generated. An attribute required to wield the best one-handed, two-handed swords, the best firearms. I feel like early on guns stink, so I'm gonna go agility to kick things off there. Beautiful talents. Choose the talent in which to invest your starting point to progress in your own way. Pretty neat that they let you just kind of roll with it, although tricky because you don't know what any of these things really do. Gathering sites become easier to see. Well, that also gives you contextual dialogue options, which I like. Craft basic weapon and armor upgrades. Pass through certain difficult passages that require balance. Wait, what? Certain difficult passages? There's going to be like little tiny passageways that are all wobbly. Charisma. Success in dialogue. Science. Lockpicking is pretty sweet. I really like the idea of picking locks, but I also like up here charisma, success in dialogue. But just because I want to be able to get in everywhere early, I'm going to go with lockpicking. Thank you very much. Let's roll.
Just a few more minutes. You have such an incredibly singular face. That's a compliment, my lady, out of my mouth. Your particularity gives you character.
You're still here?
We have nearly finished. Have you any more need of me, Master?
You haven't forgotten that we're setting sail today, have you?
Of course not.
Your cousin is nowhere to be found. I've searched the palace from cellars to attics. Your uncle is beside himself.
He was of a mind to paint the town last night. Don't worry, I shall track him down. Make care to your own preparations without wrinkling another frown. We'll meet you on the boat.
It's about time your cousin took account of the responsibilities awaiting him. He should go and inform the ambassadors of Telemi and the Bridge Alliance of his departure.
Have no fear, Master. I will go and see them in his name. I beg your pardon, but urgent matters call me away. Might we finish all this later?
Impossible, my lady! You are leaving with the tide, if what I've been told is correct.
I am sorry, sir, truly. I must be going.
My lady, please, I beg you! Her Highness
has personally requested I finish this.
Thank you, cousin, for getting me out of that.
And away we go in the palace. Go say goodbye to your mother. This is how every video game should start. Borderlands 3, say goodbye to your mom. Gears of War 5, Kate, say goodbye to your mom. Pokemon Sword and Shield, you do probably say goodbye to your mom, but that's what we need from every video game in 2019. Alright, so the world, looking a little like, it's kind of got the textures of like, it reminds me of, I don't mean this, well, it's going to sound bad, so I don't know if I should say it, but I don't mean it in a terrible way. It kind of reminds me of like PS3 games with that shine, like the Sony shine back in that era.
Kurt.
And so the day has finally come. My royal fledglings are leaving the nest.
Accompanied by their most loyal and tenacious master of arms.
As loyal as your goal.
Enough with the cold mercenary. I know you like us. Still hiding your men in the unsuspecting shadows of the greats of this world, I see.
Hey, our blades are the only thing keeping you dainties alive.
Kurt, I'm not in need of your protection. I'm no longer a child, you know.
Is that so? Well, let's see. Fight with honor!
I used to love the look of the Sony titles. I mean, I still do. But I love them back in that era. I thought it was such a cool look. So this is like a prettier version of that. Got some blades going on. Nice, nice, nice. So that's like a... Ooh, wow. Interesting attacks. All right. We got dodges and parries. Good parry. There we go. Good dodge. Good parry. Ooh. Our fists go like freaking Kratos. And get all feisty fury. Okay, so we lock on. Ow, alright. Love this is just giving us a little bit of everything. Tactical pause will pause the game and allow you to choose your next action. Access spells, skills, and potions. Or you can learn more about enemies. Okay. Let's bind that to... up on the D-pad. Thank you. And we can also use one. Drink that potion, girl. Alright, let's prove that we can fight some more. Here we go. Parry. Ooh, goodness gracious. Okay, let's use Fury. I don't know what it's gonna do. Whoa! Goodness gracious. I think this guy is gonna take us down. Probably supposed to happen that way. Fury look nice. Fury looks real nice, actually. I like Fury a lot. And yeah, Kurt with the kill.
KO!
Me who thought myself a competent weapons master.
It's becoming a little hard to believe.
Don't add insult to injury. This is humiliating enough. We'll need to get you through the basics, or you risk getting your feathers plucked at the first sign of trouble.
That could definitely come in handy.
In that case, Otto here is going to be your training partner. Go! Fight with honor!
All right, let's go. Me and Otto about to learn about freaking guns. What are we trying to do? Assign the pistol to a shortcut. There we go. All right, let's put pistol, I guess, on right bumper. That seems about right. We also have a lighter, or a light. Gotta reload. Nice, that looks pretty good. I like that. Armor. Physical armor level is shown as shields. Armor absorbs part of the physical damage. Use an impact weapon or traps. Break through your opponent's armor. Whoa. You guys can't hit me like that. Yikes, a mania. You'd think the gun would... Yeah, the gun's breaking through the armor pretty good, but we can set a trap. Come to me. Run into it. Yeah. Explosive bear trap. It's quite nice. The bears are not going to be friendly after they find that on the floor. Fury's estate that allows you to use special attacks that inflict bonus damage and make enemies lose their balance. A segmented meter that fills up as you attack an enemy casts a spell or parry attacks from enemies will allow you to see your Fury level. When the meter reaches the first level, a visual effect will appear in your kit. Oh, that's why we got those fire hands. Okay, ow. Oh, I used all my... Okay, so you have to use parries and counter attacks to fill it up. There we go. That's nice. I like that. Cool, cool. That's Fury. Sheath our weapon so that people stop being angry. Everyone's freaking very angry.
It appears we've brushed up on the basics.
It does. And I'd like to be on my way. I've quite the list of things to do before we depart.
Indeed. Remember that you can always train in our barracks on the island if you're feeling rusty.
Are your bags packed for the great departure?
Yes. You know I get by with very little. You're not angry that I'm coming with you, I hope.
Eh. Don't really like this Otto guy. No, that's not Otto. This is Kurt. Sorry. Don't like either of them. Otto freaking trying to kill me. Kurt trying to kill me. I'm actually bleeding. I don't think you know that. That's not fake health. That's real life.
I have to admit, I thought my days as a child complete with bodyguard were behind me.
I do like being wanted. It would seem that the prince didn't feel you were apt to take care of yourselves alone. And so it goes. By the way, where is our future governor hiding? I was hoping to put his skills to the test as well.
I've no idea. He had plans to celebrate his departure last night, and we haven't seen him since. You know, Constantine. I should have gone with him, but my heart wasn't in the mood for a celebration. The thought of bidding my mother farewell.
It is never easy to say goodbye. But you should be going to see her now. She must be waiting for you. I'll meet you in front of the palace. Then we'll go and find Constantine together.
Very well. I'll meet you as soon as I've said my goodbyes.
Alright, so combat definitely seems interesting. A lot of options, and the whole pause menu thing is very interesting. Going to bring some tactical tricks to the fight. It feels a little delayed, like the attacks aren't 100% perfect. But I like the flexibility that it's displayed already. But time to say bye to our family. Oh, wow.
What is this?
More like a grandma.
Have you not been taught to knock? I've asked 1,000 times. Oh, it's you. My dear child. Mother, I'm sorry. I'm having trouble getting used to your condition. Come now, let's speak of more pleasant things. I'm so very happy to hear your voice. You remind me so much of your father. I do miss him so. Today is the big day, isn't it? Ready to set sail for that island everyone's talking about. Yes, but the idea of leaving you behind, alone and ill. Dying, my child. Alas, there is nothing you can do by staying that would ease my suffering.
One thing brings me cheer. They say the island is full of miracles, and we might find a cure.
Even if I were to find it, I would never be able to return in time to...
I know. But it brings me comfort to know my daughter has left on a mission to heal her people. Come now. It is time for you to take leave. Here. Take this with you.
What is it?
A family heirloom. Something that... Take it and keep it with you. May it bring you good luck. All my blessings go with you, my child. Now, be off.
Got some serious eye affliction there. I don't know, just basic blindness or burn blindness or some magical issue. We got a freaking coin, though. And a hat, dude. I look like Puss in Boots. I feel like Shrek is about to... You know what we need? We need a Shrek RPG. That is what I'd love to see. A Shrek RPG would... That would get my $80. I'd pay more than retail for a AAA Shrek RPG with beautiful graphics, the actual voice cast, so many good moves. Imagine the incredible skill tree that Shrek would build out. Now that's what we need. In 2020.
Cut. It's done.
Sorry, Greenblood. Look, we can see the masts of the ship that'll be taking us. This is one sacred adventure we're embarking on.
I hope this island will keep its promises.
In order to know that, we'll need to find Constantine first.
You were right. Maybe he is already at the port. He was so eager to leave.
This will be quite the chore to finish before our departure. The commander wants to recover some merchandise from our supplier, but the transporter doesn't want to deliver. I did all I could to persuade. Nothing came of it. All the parliamenting fatigues me. But this is your domain. I wouldn't say no to a little help.
Of course. Where is the supplier located?
In the lower boroughs, near the port.
Right then. We'll put it on our list of visits.
All right, team setup. Kind of don't like Kirk. Kind of don't want to add him to my team, but he does have 900 HP. And he's got level 8, 2, and 5, it looks like. Melee weapons. He's a combat master and can wear heavy armors. Thank you, sir. Appreciate ya. All right. You can follow the details of your quest log.
Where would you like to begin?
I've been asked to pay visits to the ambassadors of Teleme and the Bridge Alliance before our departure. Their dwellings are not far from here. We could go there first.
Very well. Do you think Constantine will be waiting for us next to the ship?
I don't know, but it is certainly worthy of inspection.
In an odd way, doesn't it give you like Dark Souls, Demon Souls vibes just with how like grimy the world is, the way it looks as we enter the town? Take our talents away from the port and dock and towards the major portion of the city. Is this, it's locked? Well, I need to notify the freaking bridge ambassador about my departure, but it's a little tricky when the... Okay, show me the map. Aha, we are gonna have to go around, I see. Going around is fine. We've also got this ambassador. Double ambassador duty for us here before we leave for our Fairytale Island. Alright. Ooh! The prince's place is kind of on fire. You guys okay over here? You okay?
I wish you a good day, Your Excellency.
Thanks for wishing me a good day, but I'm worried about your day. The freaking... How is this not going to cause major problems in this district here? I think I gotta... Okay. Wait, what did that say? Bridge Alliance Embassy. Yeah, this has to be where we're trying to... Where we're trying to get to. Nice. No loads on the entry. That's super important. The camera movement is just a little slow. I don't know if you can tell, but, like, there's definitely, like, some, like, sludge. Pretty cool-looking character, though. I'm a fan.
Your Excellency.
Lady de Sade. I have been told that you were named Legate. Congratulations. Those are great responsibilities for someone as young as yourself. But you will bring honor upon your family and the congregation. Of that I'm certain.
I thank you, Excellency. I've come here to inform you of our departure for Tiafredi. My cousin Constantine is taking office as governor of New Serene, and I'm accompanying him.
I had no idea you would be leaving so quickly. What a shame. I had thought... Well, then, that is a pity. Have a pleasant voyage. A brilliant future awaits you. They say that it is a marvelous island. Please convey to your cousin my congratulations and sincere wishes for success.
You seem slightly hesitant. Please, tell me what troubles you.
A rather unscrupulous individual has been sowing trouble in Serene. A charlatan passing himself off as an alchemist.
Do people actually give credence to these lies?
Alas, yes. They snatch up his celebrated panacea. Remedies worse than the ill, believe me. As you can well imagine, alchemists are our pride. This vulgar trickster casts dirt upon their reputation and our own at the same time. In any city of the Bridge Alliance, we would have arrested him. But here, we respect your laws.
I shall see what I can do, but make no promises. My departure is imminent.
I thank you, Excellency. And I am pleased to see you have taken so well to your new functions of diplomacy. The man operates in the city center. He is said to be clever and mean. Be careful.
Clever and mean. All right. That's exactly what I like to hear.
Goodbye, Excellency.
Goodbye, Lady Desade.
Desade. What a fancy freaking name. All right. Out we go. All right, Kurt, what do you think we should do? We've got the Helem ambassador needs to know about our departure. Can we access it this way? I think we can. All right. I love our little, like, crouch that we can creep by. Back to Prince's Palace. And over to another door and another ambassador. Probably another side quest pickup here, huh?
Good day, Excellency.
Lady Desade, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I have come to inform you that my cousin Constantine and I are departing for Tiafredi on the hour.
Ah, yes. I did indeed hear talk that you had both received callings of greater stature. Allow me to congratulate you. Were you not named legate of the congregation?
You are correct, Excellency. I thank you.
It is a station of great honor that I am sure you will fill with brio and panache. The Mother Cardinal Cornelia will be enchanted to work with you and your cousin in the future. I only regret that your departure is so sudden.
Really?
To be entirely honest with you, I was hoping to solicit your help in a rather delicate matter.
Tell me more about it, and perhaps I can take care of your problem before my departure.
Very well. A small group of dangerous heretics has found refuge in Serene. We know that your uncle tolerates the presence of all pagans within the city walls. But these particular non-believers threaten the fragile harmony of this place. We would consider it a tremendous favor if you would arrest them and deliver them to our guard.
Heresy is not a crime in Serene. You do know that, but I'm sure that my uncle would hear your arguments. Why call on my intervention?
The prince would indeed give us his blessing, but it would take time. Far too much time. For according to our sources, these fugitives have already made contact with a smuggler to take them who knows where.
I see. You were hoping that I'll be able to do something before they make it to an enemy city. If your heretics are planning on boarding a ship, then they must be in the dockyards. I'll look into this and see what I can do. I must be going. Farewell, Excellency.
May the light guide you, Desade.
Dude has some nice wrinkles. Kind of got a William Dafoe look going on there. All right. So, Cavern of Vasco is where we need to take our talents if we want to actually take off, but we do have a vendor to negotiate with. There's also right here is what, the charlatan, so we can go complete both of these probably pretty quickly to kind of see what side quests are like before we board the boat and get out of here, which we absolutely will do today. I'm not interested in staying on this island for the entire video. We'll check it out in a bit, but let's talk to the merchant, see what's up.
Good day, my lady.
Dude, everyone's got these weird eye conditions. What is going on?
You can
on?
Start by explaining to me why you refuse to honor the orders agreed upon with the guard.
There's been a misunderstanding, madam. Of course we're ready to honor the orders. In fact, I've already had a word with your master at arms.
They're asking that we pay again, despite having already paid.
It's just that the price has gone up since. I've nothing to do with it.
This is inadmissible. If you agree on a sum, you need to honor that agreement.
I'm sorry, madam. I'm just an agent, and I'm only obeying orders.
Your master has apparently asked you to demand a second payment for this merchandise.
That's right. He told me that their attendant seemed to be hiding something when he passed the order. And so he must have thought the guard would end up paying in the end whatever he asked for.
I'll be damned. And I'm the one they've sent to settle the affair.
Sorry, Captain. It's nothing personal. I'm only following orders.
Following orders? Yeah, we hear you. Makes one wonder which one of the two of us is a coin guard.
Why don't we go and solicit other suppliers, Kurt?
When we've already paid for the merchandise. If these thieves agree to reimburse the original payment, it's what we do immediately. And do know, in the future, we won't be shopping with them. Well, I should think not.
This whole story sounds suspicious and stinks of a scandal. You were demanding a second payment, but refused to reimburse the one that was already made.
I'm not the one demanding nor refusing. It's my master.
This stubborn fool is pushing me to madness. You understand now why I'm asking for your help?
Okay. Now we have an interesting dilemma here. We can offer a bribe, but we don't have intuition. We can threaten him, or we can threaten a prison sentence, which is a 50-50 shot of working out. This dude who's got, again, is that the greed fall? Is their eyes, they get greedy, and then it just starts taking away their actual sight because their inner sight for only money? I'm getting way too deep with this. Let's just go with the charisma.
I don't think you understand who you were dealing with. Perhaps I failed to present myself properly. Lady de Sade, niece of the Prince d'Orsay and legate of the Congregation of Merchants. During our conversation, you explained to me that your master forced you to commit a crime. That's regrettable, especially as you will be considered his accomplice in extortion and theft. You know as well as I that the congregation does not tolerate such illegal activities.
But I'm only obeying orders.
That's a shame. Well, as orders are the only language you seem to understand, I order you to return the guard the merchandise without delay. Unless you'd rather your master is hung, and that you finish your days in prison.
As you request, m'lady. I shall go immediately and ask that these crates be delivered to the attendant.
Now that's a wise decision.
Thank you. I was beginning to think this would never end. You're certainly honoring your new title. Phew. Bravo! Phew. The quartermaster must be expecting us.
All right. Beautiful. So our charisma with a 50-50 shot was, Oh, goodness gracious, this is not... Oh, wow, okay. Okay, let's, pause. Hello. That guy is doing nice. Elemental traps, health potions. Goodness gracious. Alright. There we go. Yeah, we gotta get... I don't like that they can attack basically the same time I can. It's kind of scary.
Move away. Things are about to get dicey.
Cool, we're good though. Yeah, Kurt and me doing good work here. Yep, that's a parry and a kill. Okay. Thanks for the loot, man. 3 gold coins. Goodness gracious, that was spooky. Didn't know we could come across combat in the city like that, though. I kind of do like the combat system. It'll take a little while to get used to, I think. Just because, like, the speed of it is something that you're gonna have to tango with a bit. Get used to, like, the blocking, the parrying, the guns. But I like that they're just there. Just hanging out. Okay, let's go talk. And let this guy here know that we've made a deal. And, it's high time. They stop trying to, trying to mess with Desiree and Kurt.
Lady Desade, I presume. It is an honor to make your acquaintance. Captain, you set sail soon. Have you seen to our little business?
Yes. We were finally able to recover your merchandise.
Excellent news. I'm afraid, though, that your mission isn't completely finished, Kurt.
Blast me. I'm a captain, not an errand boy.
The commander was quite explicit.
Very well. What do I need to do?
The merchandise that you obtained needs to be sent to Tirfredi as soon as possible. But the Port Authority formalities for shipping take an eternity to wade through. And we've already lost quite a bit of time with this dishonest merchant.
Are you blatantly asking us to smuggle this merchandise in contraband?
I would never ask you to do such a thing, Your Excellency.
Ah, but you don't mind asking that of Kurt?
Well, now, if he finds an alternative solution that is less, illegal, that would be fine. The method matters not. But this cargo must reach the Isle on the next ship.
Marvelous.
Well then, I await your return with utmost impatience. I'm certain you shall do what's required.
Smuggling? This really... Look, see? This game is kind of a lot like Pirates of the Caribbean. Even if we're not directly a pirate, we're smuggling, we're ship sailing. Find a way to move the cargo to Tirfredi. Alright, so that's all going to be back here. Captain Vasco, the smuggler, all in this area, I guess? Wait, there's the smuggler here. That's the charlatan. Let's go that way. It's super nearby. Yeah, it's only 29 meters. Let me complete these side quests and hopefully get on the boat, baby. Alright, search the area for the charlatan. Gotta be right here.
Citizens, I present to you Panacea, the absolute cure of everything.
Oh, that sounds legit.
Toothache, stomach ailment, and even an open wound. This potion heals all of that. And more still, this little phial is the product of years of research and intensive labor. I hear you asking if this remedy can heal one from the Malachor. Alas, not yet. But your question is legitimate. I am so close to finding the cure. But the Malachor isn't the only ailment causing you to suffer. Not true? Then don't miss out on this chance and give yourself a healthy and energized life. Rejoice! A phial only costs a few coins, and well worth it to make your life shiny and new again.
Does it really heal everything, your potion?
Everything. Absolutely everything. Except the Malachor, of course. That being said, it is known that those in top health resist the Malachor best of all. Then don't throw away this chance. Think of all the pains that this potion could help you avoid.
You are right. It's a deal. I'm gonna take two.
There's a man that knows a good deal when he sees one. Hurry now. There won't be enough for everyone.
There he is. He's our man, no doubt.
The panacea.
The speech is well polished. I even feel like buying some.
That's what he sells.
If we had a word with him, I wonder if he'll serve us the same routine.
But what's most interesting is the Malachor must be the eye condition that I keep mentioning, the weird freaking roots of pain and magic on the face. And we have a little bit of it, but the mother, grandmother, the merchant, and more have so much. So let's find out what it is. Hey now.
Ah, you're finally tempted.
In all honesty, I haven't made up my mind yet. I want to be certain that I'm not dealing with a charlatan.
In this day and age, I can't blame you. What might I do to convince you?
Demonstrate it.
Will you drink one of your potions to prove your good faith?
Of course. I take a little sip every morning. But as I'm in perfect health, you won't be able to verify the improvement in my condition. But if it helps you make up your mind, give me just a moment. There now. As you see, I am still in excellent condition.
Come on now. I saw you take that vial out of your pocket. Nothing proves that it's the same potion that you sell to your clients.
As a man of science, I consider skepticism a remarkable quality. But in your case, it is not skepticism, but blindness.
We need to steal one of these potions and force him to drink it.
Brilliant idea, Kurt. Let's take a look at his cart.
Told you these dudes were pirates. Forced potion drinking. Definitely the work of a pirate. Alright, Tell me more. This is his cart, right? Oh, we have to go back. Okay. So let's sneak around. So he doesn't see us. I'm sure he doesn't care. It's just beginning side quest. Birdman! Love those masks. Always have. Alright. Back in the alley, we will find a little bit of his potion here. Letter from the innkeeper, the servant, the weird alchemist of the Alliance who rented a room upstairs asked us not to clean it during his stay. Okay, so he's got stuff up in the, oh! Okay.
And death to the others.
Yep, gotta love those gunshots. That's the way to roll, baby. Finish him off. There we go. Yeah! Good kick, knock him down. Finish the fight. There we go. Good work, everybody. He's dead. Absolute evisceration there. We're starting to get a handle on things. See that? Really coming through here. Ooh, old cutlass axe. I don't want this. Can you sell it? I guess you can for 7. I might as well just take everything at this point. Inside this chest, magic potion. Soft old boots. I guess we can check out the inventory screen here. It's our journal. Here's equipment. Nothing on our back, but we do have boots that can be modified. We got worse boots. Okay. Their quality is better, but they're worse armor, but I guess better elemental resistance? Sure. At least they look a lot different. Kurt has his own stuff going on. Rusty stiletto, old rusted saber. Our pistol here feeling pretty good. Alright, cool, cool. Still gotta get into his apartment somehow. Recipe books. Oh, his room is here. This is the room they didn't want him to clean? Really now? I thought it was gonna be an interior space. This dude doesn't even have enough cash to get a room inside. He's got rats crawling through his creepy outdoor abode. Of course his stuff is fake. He can't even sell it for enough to pay for a room. Listen up, buddy. Drink your potion.
Have you finally made up your mind?
I happen to have a vial of your medicine. Would you be willing to drink it in front of us? To prove that there is no risk?
This bullying is trying my patience. I'm beginning to suspect that you might be working for a rival.
You refused to taste it?
You might have put something in it to cause me harm or further disgrace.
No, look. The vial is still sealed. It comes straight from your stock.
And you dare challenge me? When you have just admitted to being a thief.
Come now. You can see for yourself that I am gladly returning your vial, so that you might drink it in front of witnesses. This might help to dissipate my doubts, as well as those of these brave folk.
Yes, no, I... You don't have the right!
Damnation. He got away. He can't have gone far.
Find him, before his head ends up on a spike.
Okay. Think back to the note that we found. We need to take a look at the tavern.
To the tavern.
We won't leave the city without
I love that there's no loads for the indoor environments. That's huge. Huge, huge, huge. In a game like this, where inevitably there's going to be a lot of in-out talking and such, and to have no load screens yet is pretty freaking remarkable. All right, where did this dude take off to? I also love how we're so really, really obsessed with proving him wrong. Like, we're not going to let someone sell fake freaking snake oil around here. Yeah, that camera could use work. Our lockpicking gets a test, though, and it just works. All right, cool. No minigame there. We get some gloves, a better hat, and an old dagger. Let's check this out. Here we go. Alright. Let's see. This old dagger is better. It does have a little bit... Oh, it requires agility too. I can't equip it yet. Dang it. Okay. We're quite close to making it awesome. What about our hat here? Let's see. That is better. A better hat. For sure. Down. It says down balance, even though... Oh, it's down in every way. It just has better loot. It has worse armor. But it's better quality poison resistance. But losing armor is just kind of hard. Alright, we do have different gloves. Are they better? They are better. Finally something better. Thank you. Thank you, my dear. Alright. Where could this guy be? Did he leave? The charlatan is around here somewhere, just not quite sure where. There he is.
You again? What are you doing in my room?
I'm not the only one that's found you. Have you seen the mob that's gathering in the street?
I'm neither deaf nor blind. By the spheres. Why didn't I leave the city while there was still time?
The Alliance ambassador is quite unsettled by your commerce, and he's the one who sent me.
Sahin! Him again. Ruining my career wasn't enough for him. He's the very reason I had to leave the Alliance. And here I am, playing the part of the potion maker. Me, who was once a respected member of the Academy of Al-Saad.
Why does Sahin bear you such hatred?
I was unfortunate enough to oppose certain great minds of the Academy. To criticize their methodology. I saw them inflicting torture on sick prisoners. Making them drink the most vile poisons. To find a remedy to the Malachor they won't hesitate to kill. I could not keep my silence.
It is for an act of courage that you fell from grace and earned Sahin's hatred. Are you not ashamed to have poisoned those poor souls?
These potions are not harmful. That is to say that they don't contain any harmful ingredients.
But you could just as easily produce real healing potions. So why don't you?
You don't understand. I fled. But I haven't put a stop to my own research. This potion is an attempt to create in those who drink it a resistance to the Malachor.
So you manipulate people to use as experimental fodder? That is completely unethical.
I don't have a choice, but it does not harm them, I assure you.
If this potion were inoffensive, then why wouldn't you drink it when I offered it to you?
I ran tests on myself for such a long time that I ended up becoming intolerant to it. A small sip of this mixture provokes in me now a violent reaction. The mob would have been furious in any case, but a normal dose, I assure you, is without risk.
Okay, if you say so, dude. It's a little suspicious and a little sneaky, but we'll let you go, I think.
Dr. Sahin warned me that you were an imposter.
That doesn't surprise me, coming from him. I was a master alchemist. I understand if you don't believe me after all that. But I have a number of documents to prove it. I would still be one if Sahin hadn't set off a chain of machinations to disgrace me.
Your methods don't seem so different than those of your colleagues.
I don't torture people. And this potion only has side effects in high doses.
Perhaps. But you are hurting innocence. I cannot let your commerce continue.
So, what are you going to do with me, my lady?
Ooh. He doesn't seem like a bad dude, and he's way too wrinkly to waste the rest of his years in jail, so we'll just help him get out of here.
I'm going to help you leave the city, but you must promise never to return.
I swear it.
Very well, then. I need to first get you away from those who want to see you hanged.
If we can't find a way to sneak out of here discreetly, we will have to confront the populace.
I haven't lost hope that I'll be able to help them hear reason.
It would be better if I remain hidden while waiting.
All right. So we gotta sneak out of here. Unless we want to try and talk with the angry crew. Negotiate with the angry crowd. What is this? Talk to the innkeeper downstairs. Is there a way to just bust a move out of here, do you think? Think we can just like slip out of... Are there windows that you can jump from? Is that a thing in this game? Please let me open the window. This looks like a nice window. Yeah, my least favorite thing so far is how... Like, whoosh. The camera kind of makes me a little nauseous given how... laggy it is on the turn. It's just not smooth. If they had that fixed, it would make things so much better. Okay, you think there's any discreet way out of here? Any of these back rooms have... exit path. I thought those were pumpkins for a second. It's cheese wheels.
The servant's door. Ooh. The lock's double bolted.
All right, where do we think the key might be? Here's the storeroom key. So we got it. We grabbed that one upstairs. It looks like there's some loot in here. Gold coins, innkeeper's key, metal dowels, and crude iron ore. Sweet. So now we should be able to sneak out and not deal these people so we can get to our ship.
Locked.
Okay.
Let's go and find the alchemist. We need to get him out of here as fast as we can.
Okay. Let's escort the charlatan. I don't want to negotiate with the angry crowd. We're done with that. So... is everything this way? No, that's the smuggler. Oh, I guess we'll just escort the Charlotte. Is he with us? Old man, are you? No, he's not. It said escort the charlatan, but I guess he's not here. I love that you can just go in and out. How freaking cool is that? Random building. Alright. Guys, gonna help me get out of here?
Excuse me.
Still want to not deal with the angry crowd? Oh, this is the tavern again. So this is where I was. Wait, this is also the tavern though, right? Okay. I really don't want to negotiate with the angry crowd. Seems like a very bad idea. Okay, maybe we can still sneak by. Okay, looks like we can. Looks like we can still not deal with them. Alright. So, yeah, I don't want to negotiate the angry crowd. Alright. So we gotta head all the way over here. I think going the long way is gonna make the most sense so that we don't have to worry about that. Alright. I'm guessing if we just go to the docks, then the charlatan should follow us. Let's quickly check out our what's our quest log look like? Oh, you still have to negotiate with the angry crowd. Okay, that's interesting. I didn't think it was I thought that was our like alternate option was getting the heck out of there, you know, but I guess that's still part of the quest. Well, shoot, didn't you think that if we snuck our way out of the tavern we wouldn't have to negotiate? I kind of took it to mean all right, but maybe it presents us with a better option because we're coming from behind, I guess. Hey guys, it's okay.
Please listen, I beg you.
If you want him to reimburse you, get in the back of the line like everyone else.
Believe me, I understand why you are angry.
Me? It's not money I want. That charlatan tried to poison us. I couldn't give a flying pile of dung for your pretty words. We're gonna hang him high. And you too, if you're an accomplice.
How absurd. I'm the one who put an end to his operation.
Well, in that case, help us catch him so he can be punished like he deserves.
He's trapped. He'll have to come out someday, you'll see.
I don't have any intuition, but, get out of here.
Citizens, in my capacity as legate of the congregation, I order you to disperse.
Disperse? It's that thief you should be arresting. You hear me, everyone? The powerful are behind this charlatan. They want us to leave.
We'll have nothing of it. Arm yourselves!
Oh, great. We get to fight them?
To my house.
Goodness gracious. Kurt drinking freaking steroid potions over here. I hate that we're just fighting freaking citizens, but, you know, it is what it is.
Move away. Things are about
double trouble. Take out. Oh, God. I hate that we have to do this to people, but it is what it is. Oh, wow. Okay. There we go. Good knockback. Get the kill on the ground. And then this dude can go down. Take him down. Alright, ooh, this armed guy is tough.
Move away.
I wish I could parry him, but he's all about Kurt here. His armor is almost done. I could have laid a trap, but I kind of want to save those. Yeah, we got you now.
The alchemist is not far from danger, at least.
Go and tell him the good news.
I did level up, though, which is awesome. Thanks for the gold coins and the silver bracelet. Got a lot of loot here. A bandit's hat. I'll take the coins. Don't need that. Health potion and gold coins. Cool. Charlatan, what's up? How you doing? Tell the alchemist that he's free to go because we killed everyone that he sold potions to. That is one way to deal with your mismanaged merchandise. Hey, did you buy this? Yes, okay. Blech. Gonna slice you and dice you and everything nice you until you're out of here.
So, did you find a way to get me out of this hornet's nest?
I have gotten rid of the mob.
Bravo.
Literally got rid of them.
You don't go about things in a roundabout.
Literally, alchemist.
You are free. Climb into your carriage and leave Serene immediately. Let me deal with Dr. Sahin.
I owe you my life, my lady. I will be eternally in your debt.
I remind you to never step foot here again.
I have no desire to return anyway. Farewell.
That Malachor creeping across our face. Looking like some sort. Yes, let's go. You're right. That's nice. Directly back with a load screen. And it's almost instantaneous. Holy crap. That is so impressive in a game like this. I hope it always stays that way no matter if we're in the starting area or not. But yeah, that Malachor is creeping across my face after getting a good look of it. Kind of looks like we're going to turn into a robotic entity. That would be the biggest twist in this game. Greedfall is actually a future game. After everyone turns into freaking chrome robots. It's like that episode of SpongeBob.
Your Excellency.
Lady de Sade.
I tracked down your man near the Coin Guard barracks.
Finally.
Did you capture him?
Let's just say that I put an end to his activities. His reputation in Serene is forever tarnished. Matters turned out a little more complicated than anticipated.
We'll cover the escape.
He managed to slip through our fingers.
Once again. That man is part eel.
Part
eel?
We
followed his trail to the Coin Guard Tavern, but he had already escaped. All the same, you have nothing to fear. He will never step foot in Serene again.
We'll eventually catch up with him and deliver the punishment that his crimes deserve. Governor Burhan will be happy to learn that such an amiable legate will soon cross the shores of Tir Fredi. Thank you for your help, Excellency, and allow me to offer you this modest gift for your voyage.
I need to be going. Goodbye, Excellency.
Goodbye, Lady de Sade.
Alright, quest complete. Time to get on that boat. Time to also check out our freaking skill tree. Oh, God. Okay. So, we've got our traps here. We can pick one more skill. Tagging one-hand blades deals more damage. These are already all acquired, right? Yeah, one-hand blades. Firearms deal 20% more damage. Stasis. Completely immobilize the enemy for the duration of the effect. Oh, I like that. Ooh, Divine Magic Ring, Shadow Missile, Furious Magical Attack. Stasis sounds pretty cool too, though. It costs 2 points, though. Those basic skills all cost 2. Otherwise, I can just get, like... Dang. Ugh. Do we want to save for Stasis or spend on, like, better firearm damage? I guess we'll spend here to get a skill. No attribute points and no skill points. Those are acquired at level 3, 4, and, or at 4 and 5, as you can see there. Alright, but I am now level 3, so are we able to... Oh, it's agility 2. It's not level. I'm level 2. It's agility 2 is what they needed. Okay, let's get the heck out of here. It's time to go. Present ourselves to the captain. We can finally... Get the heck out of here. Good grief. It's time to go. It's time to go indeed. Let's make sure we're taking a proper path. Yeah, down and then to the right. Alright, cool. Next alley. And we'll veer hard right. Okay, we can finally get off this freaking island of misfits and Malachor and see what it's like to set sail. We're actually almost to level 3. We got a lot of XP from that fight against the freaking citizens, which I feel... pretty guilty about, if I'm honest. Okay. What do you guys think of the game so far? Like I said, save for the camera. It's pretty darn cool. Alright, hello? Zones controlled by other factions. This zone is under control of another faction. Okay, well, I'm not gonna try to mess around with that back alley controlled by another faction. Let's just see if we can get to our main ship. Aha, yes, yes, yes. That's our boat. I wonder if we actually get to drive the boat.
Lively there, lads and lasses! I promised the merchants and their prince we'd be off before the tide. You, man, carry that properly. That porcelain is worth more than your life. There are some children we'd be best to refuse.
Captain Vasco.
And you are?
I'm De Sade, the prince's niece. All is in order. We will soon be embarking on your boat.
It's a ship. Not a boat.
Apologies.
Apologies for my asking, but the young governor isn't with you.
He didn't come home this morning. I need to find him before departure.
I hope nothing's happened to him or he hasn't changed his mind. The tide does not wait.
Perhaps he simply celebrated his imminent departure with a little too much enthusiasm. Is everything ready?
We're short a crew member. The cabin boy is missing. But have no fear, we will leave without him if he does not present himself before the tide.
Is he an important member of the crew?
We don't need him for sailing or navigation. He's only a cabin boy.
He must have simply had a bit too much to drink in celebrating his departure. Like another I know.
I doubt that. Jonas was never one to fancy drink. And it's been 2 days since last he was seen. No, I fear something bad has happened to him. Might I ask you, if you hear anything, could you report it to me? I would like to set sail with a clear mind.
Okay. Let's,
Be back soon, Captain.
Let's go find Constantine. I think Vasco, I don't think he has Malachor. I think he just painted on his face the Sharpie. Being a bit of a weird one, making a little bit of a freaking face mess. Don't think that's a disease, unless he wants to try to be cool like everybody else and have a little bit of Malachor, but I really feel like that is more his own messiness and tattoo work than Malachor. Alright, put your weapon away. No. Not time for that. Thanks for the Hawthorne. Alright. Looks like we're going back to the tavern to try and figure out where Constantine is. We gotta get on this ship, cabin boy. You're lost, but you may have to stay that way. De Sade has more than one string to his bow. or Herbo. Cunning, persuasion, intuition, corruption, creating items from the crafting table will be some of the means to reach your goals. Threats and combat are also options. Interesting. So there's a lot of flexibility here, and it's showing itself bit by bit.
Good day, Tavern Keeper.
Good day to you. What is your pleasure?
I'm looking for my cousin. His name is Constantin. I believe he was intent on celebrating his departure last night.
There was indeed a party here last night, but it ended badly.
Whatever do you mean?
A brawl broke out. My tavern was shattered, and no one's paid for the damages.
I'm sorry. Amongst the rebel rousers, did there happen to be a young man? 20 years of age? Hair down to his neck, light brown? Blue eyes? Quite the talker?
I don't believe it. Of course he was there. He's the man that started the fight. I hope you've come to reimburse me. Don't count on me to help you if that's not the case.
What kind of damage are we talking about exactly?
A good half of my furniture was broken into firewood. I piled up the lot over there.
Let me take a look. Perhaps it can be repaired.
If you can fix it, I'd be obliged. If not, you'll need to pay.
Great. Oh, gosh. We have a lot of gold. Let's just pay
here
for
you are,
it.
To cover your
gotta
expenses.
Get to this boat, baby.
Excellent. Honest books makes for honest friendships. Your cousin is either a very bad joker or a right good fool. He went and insulted a band of ruffians from the lower boroughs. Dangerous fellows. They've a storehouse they operate out of a few streets from here.
What kind of business do they run?
Several, actually, and they're all illegal and profit. In any case, if you were set on recovery...
Right,
thank you
hurry.
For the information.
Get off with ya.
Alright, thank
anything
you.
Anything else?
No, we're good to go.
I need to be off.
We
goodbye.
Are here. Goodbye, Jeffrey. Thanks for the tips and the tricks. I paid for your repairs since our cousin is a crazy person.
This furniture is in terrible condition.
Yeah.
The fight must have been extremely violent.
The furniture is in terrible condition.
I've seen worse. We'll need to build some metal dowels.
Yeah,
done,
I don't. I already paid for it, Kurt. We're good on that front. Don't need to mess with that no more. All right, we got to figure out where Constantine is after his big fight. Trying to be a young Conor McGregor here in the streets of Serene. Dude, you're in the freaking pig pile. Come on, man. That's shameful.
Any idea who I am?
Oh, he's in jail.
Open up, imbeciles! I have a ship to catch.
That vulture of a tavern master was right. It is Constantine's voice. It's coming from the floor above.
Sounds as if he's locked up.
And I have a feeling they're expecting company. Be careful. The slightest itchy word to these brutes will have them drawing blades to scratch it.
Negotiation may be the solution. As you say, this breed of brutes won't spit on ransom money.
What a waste. I'd rather sneak around them than give half a coin to these seedy fellows.
Okay, so it looks like... got a free Constantine. Two options. The sneaky option and the battle option. Okay. Let's descend down below. Thought we were gonna be descending onto the water sometime soon, but it sure doesn't seem like it. Okay. So Constantine in this way. Ooh. Level 1, science and alchemical preparation of elemental damage.
It's not possible just now.
Dang it! I don't have that stuff.
It's blocked.
Oh. Cool. So maybe the sneaky way is not possible. I don't know how it would have been possible, because we don't have skill points to spend. But there's just magic loot lying around. Ammo, leather, thank you kindly. We're gonna try to get around, I guess. Hate that we can't. I mean, the fighting will get us XP. Enemy detection. When the player is in stealth mode, your enemy's detection indicator will appear. Suspicious as yellow, detected as in red. Okay, we still get to stealth. Cool, cool.
Don't be an idiot. It's obvious that he's a noble, a rich man. He needed to be taught a lesson, but it's better we grab some coin. With all those posters we posted, someone with deep pockets will show up sooner or later to
goodness gracious, that guy was on a very, very short little navigation path there. Constantine, my dude, I'm going in the villain's den.
Well, that they have their own den. That's pretty cool. Kind of wish I had a villain's den. Maybe we could be a villain. You in there? Old boy? Ah, so we could have came in from the basement and not even had to nudge up against those spies, but it wasn't too hard at all. I don't think there's going to be any more indoors either, so it looks like we'll just get right here. Lockpick away. Thank goodness for the lockpick.
Well, this has been monumentous, gentlemen, but I have more important things to attend to. An island to govern, treaties to sign, riches to expedite, and a demanding father to crush!
Constantine, it's me!
My fair cousin! Oh, my lucky star! Always there to pull me out of my fires!
I do what I can. We are departing soon. Your father wasn't pleased by your absence this morning.
Have you ever seen him happy about anything when it comes to me? You know what he thinks of me.
He cares about you. I know that. He appointed you governor, didn't he?
He is ridding himself of a source of constant disappointment. Enough said. Today, we set sail for adventure.
If finally.
You only knew
finally.
How these river scum treated
oh
me.
Oh my goodness.
Do me a courtesy, fair cousin. Now that we stand boldly alongside the brave Kurt, let's give them their money's worth.
They haven't spotted us. We could sneak out of here silently. We have a ship to board.
You've always been the reasonable soul. Don't you think these brutes deserve a punishment?
Yes, without a doubt. But don't you think there are more pressing matters? Kurt!
It is your Highness's decision to make. Whatever it is, I shall follow.
Okay. We gotta find Constantine's clothes, which are... Here they are. Hey, he joined our freaking squad. There he is. And now we can give him his beautiful old clothes. And he looks like a real freaking sailor captain. Happy boy. Alright, cool. Checkmate, thank you. Now, we can't fight these dudes, or we can try to escape silently. I'm guessing, honestly, that maybe that basement area is actually used for this escape, rather than for a hidden entrance. So let's exit quietly, so that we can get to our ship. It's about high time we did such a thing, don't you think? Alright. Also, just random chests laying around. We've got lockpicking, so it's a chance to help out. Ammo, fury potions, haze potions. I like the sound of that. All right, let's get out of here, my dudes. I like that you have a squad, too. That's kind of interesting. So instead of having... Instead of, you know, it just being a solo RPG affair, you kind of have a party. Kind of. I wonder if eventually... I'm guessing eventually we can pick, like, who we have, who we use. Maybe outfit them a little bit. I got some hoof fungus, so, you know, this is going to definitely be an interesting one. All right. Unblock this door. There is a couple chests here. Nice, okay. Some coins and some potions. And a criminal's key. I wonder what the heck that's used for. No matter. No worries. I gotta get out of here. It's time to go. It's so time to go. We've had enough. We've had enough of criminals. We've had enough of Constantine and his goofy antics. We snuck out of here super well. Now we just gotta get the heck out of here. Wait, this is the dangerous way, right? Yeah, I probably should go around rather than pass by. Sorry to take a long way after all of this, but... Whoops, didn't mean to pull that out. I think it's probably best we don't upset the entire city before escorting ourselves out of here, and I think this is a safe alley to head down. There's also just so much. Square is what I absolutely want to press to loot, but it's X. Resuscitation powder. Alright, we're loaded up here to leave this poor place. Okay. And we're good. Ready to go. Time to flow. There's our dude. Tell the captain we're good. All three of our crew is content in the same spot. Safe? We're not gonna get the cabin boy. We don't have time for that. We gotta go. We gotta go, Vasco. Sorry, man. You'll have to draw more weird fake Malachor on your face.
Madam,
Constantine d'Orsay, future governor of Tir Fredi. I'm enchanted, Captain. I am eager to board your ship.
Enchanted as well, Your Highness. I hope you enjoy your voyage.
Are you ready? Can we weigh anchor?
We should be able to set sail with the tide, as agreed upon. I'm still without news of my cabin boy, but we will have to do without.
Yep, it's time to leave, baby.
Permission to board the ship. We are ready.
Certainly, but keep in mind that we'll be at sea for several months.
Months?
If you have any farewells to make or any final business to put into order, now is the time.
We're all good. Let's get out of here, baby.
No, my house is in order. We are ready to embark.
Perfect. Follow me.
I am so eager to discover Tir Fredi.
Isn't the boat this way, buddy? Where are you going?
My new city.
You'll need to arm yourself with patience. The voyage will be long. I've been told the trip lasts months.
Months.
And they say the place is full of gigantic creatures.
Really?
As big as buildings.
That's pretty freaking exciting.
Right. I heard a rumor the Nauts even brought one back in one of their ships.
I doubt that. The Nauts are strange, but they're not it.
Yeah. Disney Cruise, here we come.
The beast is awoken!
Those conniving, piss-distilling, bridge-building liars. The creature was supposed to be out for days.
Oh, gosh.
Paid for this.
What the hell manner of cargo are you transporting?
Help! We need ropes! We must contain it!
Help! Come freaking, sounds like George in the Jungle. What's going on? Oh, my goodness. Yep, it is Bloodborne. Holy crap, there's no way we can fight that. There's no way. What the heck kind of game is this?
Watch out! Take a step back, sir!
Oh my goodness gracious. Brilliant move by the ship crew, honestly. That was gonna eat the whole town.
Captain! Keep my cousin safe!
Oh my god, it's back though. Wait, I'm seriously. Oh my god, are you serious? Wait, you're serious. Seriously? Defeat the. Seriously? There's no way, right? This is not a thing. Is it seriously? Oh my. It doesn't. It expects me to beat this. What in the world? I wasn't crazy when they said this reminds me of. Bloodborne. I'm just gonna fire it. I don't wanna get close. Maybe we actually can kill it. Did you guys expect a massive freaking kaiju level boss battle to close this out? Holy cow. Okay, back up. Oh! Oh no, I did get killed! No! Wake up. Okay, I don't know how this... I don't know, our first load screen. That is impressive also, that until this point, no loads. You gotta give them major props for that, huh? That's really impressive. Okay.
So eager.
You ready again? Alright, I'm just gonna run and let's get the boss battle. Here we go. Take your talents to me. Okay, what up, buddy? Alright, I'm gonna try to be better here. Dodge and fire. We gotta take the... We can't beat this. Ugh. Got freaking knives in its back. Knives. Back up. Here we go. It's very unbalanced. That's painful. Ooh, that's very painful. Oh my goodness gracious. Cash that potion in. Oh my. Whoa! Oh my god. Hey, whoa. Okay, we got it. I think we got it. One more shot. Yeah. There we go. So close. Thing. did not know there were creepy Bloodborne bosses in this game tonight.
Greenblood, how do you fare?
Fine, fine. It is dead.
Are you wounded?
I'm well. Your lessons have proven effective.
I've never seen a beast this size. It's quite extraordinary.
Cousin, what a fight. You were illustrious.
I'm not of the same mind. I have the feeling it was already weakened. I did nothing more than finish it off.
Your humility remains a constant. But believe me, that battle was absolutely epic.
Okay. Level 3. Memory Crystal allows you to redistribute all the points you spent. Okay, if you want to do that. I'm gonna save a point so I can get the stasis, but I do have... No, I need to wait till level 4 for that. Okay. Cool, cool, cool. We gotta get on this ship, man. I cannot believe that thing just popped out of there. I don't think I also got this chest. No, I didn't. Thank goodness it's still there. We went back and reloaded. Alright, well, that was all sorts of creepy. The thing just bust through. Thank goodness that. I guess that's not our ship. Otherwise, we wouldn't be going anywhere because it looks quite wrecked. Instead, our ship is here.
Madam, gentlemen.
All sails set. Boss battle defeated. Boat boarded. And the game can really get going.
Your cousin's enthusiasm is most impressive.
This journey is his long-awaited chance to prove his worth. He has a demanding father.
More likely, he's just happy to be free of this hornet's nest.
I definitely know I am. That's certain.
Stations, lads! Weigh anchor and ready her to wear! Lively now, lively! Catch me a wind!
And we're off to New Serene. Old Serene was not good enough, but we're back. Pretty freaking cool, huh?
Gentlemen, I am Constantine of House Orsay, your new governor. I have no idea what sort of ceremony you've prepared for my arrival, but I would gladly skip it, so... indeed, these are rather peculiar customs. I see, it seems you are quite intent on serving me a drink. Hello? Cat got your tongue, gentlemen? Would it be those annoying beaks?
I am truly sorry these doctors should have shown a greater measure of courtesy. Thank you, dear doctors. Move along. Don't trouble the noughts. Pay no attention to them. Instead, just drink. The long voyages at sea require the appropriate treatment as soon as we land. According to our scientists, without fortifiers, you might catch your death, and that will be quite regrettable.
I should have chosen death.
This concoction is liquid torture.
I would think that they would have warned you on the ship.
No, not in the slightest. And you must be Lady Morange, my predecessor.
You are correct.
There you are!
To your health!
Aha! You got your dose of bile too. Allow me to present to you Lady Morange, and to you, my dear lady, my most trusted cousin. Where is the captain?
He seems to be preoccupied with some sort of admiral.
Indeed. Then I will have to thank him later for this most marvelous voyage. Excellency, lead me to the palace, I beg you. And, whenever possible, go by way of all the intriguing alleyways. I am dying with impatience to discover this new city. My city!
Your Excellence! We must wait for our escort!
No need! Have no fear, for I am here to defend you, my lady.
I've been scullied.
How so?
My admiral laid me off.
My cousin was nonetheless delighted with your services. I hope that there was no misunderstanding.
None, I'm sure of it. She just ordered me to give you any assistance you might need.
This request doesn't seem to please you.
Don't take offense, but it's not pleasant for a captain to abandon his ship. In any case, here I am at your service for a while.
Hey, hey, hey. We add another member to the team, and we're ready to go. A new land. I was kind of hoping we were going to go to this giant mountain with tons of creatures, but maybe that is saved for a later quest. It seems like we're in a pretty normal place to begin. Our cousin is off. The title screen hits an hour into the experience, and that's a good first look at Greedfall. What do you all think? I'd say the biggest negatives are the lag on the camera, and probably it's not the prettiest of games, but positive-wise, the combat's pretty darn cool. There seems to be a lot of flexibility in your choices and way of completing quests, and the promise of, like, big freaking giant monsters and stuff. I think there's more to this game than it initially leads on, even if it's a bit of a slow build-up. But let me know your take. Like I said, just a big video to give you a good look at Greedfall. It is out soon. What do you guys think? Hit that like button if you enjoyed the video. Let me know if you're going to check out the game in the comments down below. And until next time, everybody, thanks so much for watching. Drink some hot chocolate. I love you a lot, and we'll see you all later.